Miami-Dade County, under the leadership of Mayor Daniela Levine-Cava, is moving swiftly to expand COVID-19 vaccine distribution to protect our community and move our economy forward. Vaccine supplies are currently extremely limited, and as the state provides more vaccines to the county, we are working hard to distribute them as fast as possible. Register for vaccine updates and get more information at miamidade.gov/vaccine. Get vaccinated, Miami-Dade County. It's our best shot for a strong, healthy community.
Welcome in WDNA 88.9 FM into the Frost Jazz Hour. I'm your host, Philip Capuzzi, back with you this week after a brief hiatus. Last week, we had the incredible Extensions Ensemble live in the gallery under the direction of the incredible Kate Reed. And this morning, we have a very exciting program. Next to me, the wonderful Dante Luciani, trombone player, educator extraordinaire. And he brings in an ensemble that I'm very excited to hear today with some familiar faces and some new faces. We have in this group, which is entitled the Frost Brasstet. We'll speak a little bit about this ensemble because I'm very curious about it later in the program. But just to share the personnel with you, we have Ethan Pires on trumpet, Haoran Li on trombone, Eric Stern on piano, Drew Kaplan on upright bass, and Zach Levine rounding out the ensemble on drums. This is the Frost Jazz Hour every Thursday morning from 11 a.m. until 12 noon. We bring in some of the premier ensembles at Frost, as well as other groups led by members who have some sort of affiliation with Frost. Very exciting program, live and direct, every Thursday morning without fail. So let's just get into the music. They're going to start with an original, actually, of Eric Stern entitled Familiar Colors here on 88.9 FM, the Frost Jazz Hour. Thank you. Familiar Colors, live and direct here on WDNA 88.9 FM, the Frost Jazz Hour from the Jazz Gallery. That's an Eric Stern composition, and he's also on piano with this wonderful group, the Frost Brasstet. We'll be with you live and direct until 12 noon. I'm your host, Philip Capuzzi. Next to me, the director of this ensemble, Dante Luciani. And just to mention the musicians in this ensemble once more, we have Haoran Li on trombone, Ethan Pires on trumpet, like I said, Eric Stern on piano, also composing that last tune, Drew Kaplan on upright bass, and Zach Levine on drums. And now we're going to move forward with a Horace Silver composition entitled Metamorphosis. The Frost Brasstet, live and direct here on the Frost Jazz Hour, WDNA 88.9 FM. Thanks to everyone for tuning in so far, whether you be listening on WDNA 88.9 FM or WDNA.org, streamed live across the world. And if you're listening on one of those sources and you're interested in a video component, feel free to check out our YouTube channel, WDNA Radio, for the well-produced live stream that we have at this show every week from 11 to 12. And you can also go to livestream.com as well for that same video content. And with that, I welcome in the leader of this ensemble, Dante Luciani, into the show. Dante, thank you so much for being with us here and bringing this ensemble into the station.
Good morning. And thank you, Philip, for having us. It's a pleasure to be here, and we're really excited about today's performance, and really excited to be in the studios here. The sound is great. The video component has been really wonderful. I've been checking out the videos, and it's a great thing that's going on here every Thursday.
Yeah, thank you so much. So I'm curious about this ensemble because I wasn't privy to it in the time that I was at the school. Is this a new situation this semester?
Well, yes. Due to the COVID mitigation measures that we're enforcing at school, this is actually the group that you are an
right,
alum
that's
of.
What I was curious about.
Formerly
yeah.
The Frost Octet, Jazz Octet. But we had a limit of 6 people in the room, including me, so we decided to cut it down a little bit, and since we have brass as the front line, we dubbed it the Frost Brasstet this semester. Next semester, we'll be going back to our normal configuration, however, so.
Right, okay, good to know. So I'm curious, transitioning from the octet into now this brasstet, are there any different considerations or approaches that you take now that there's no woodwinds in the group, obviously being that there's less voices, but anything maybe that the layman wouldn't think of?
Well, as is the case with most groups that have a two-horn front line, you have to be extremely creative with the writing. You have to make the most out of two voices. And one example that I'd like to talk about is the great composer and arranger Slide Hampton, who normally would have a three-horn front line. But what he does with a few horns, really, it makes it sound really rich, and you know, using certain intervals and techniques for arranging. The other advantage is we've been able to have a lot more material that's composed by the members of the band. Most of our material is original, and I think that's really exciting. So it gives a little bit more flexibility.
Absolutely, yeah. And you kind of led me to my other question, which was, looking at the set list, half of it is represented with originals from the group.
Mm-hmm.
So I'm curious, was that something that you set out as an intention coming into this ensemble, or did it just kind of work out that way that people started bringing in tunes?
Well, fortunately, the members of the band were really excited about bringing in their own compositions, and we discussed doing transcriptions, of course, as one of our approaches, but I think that I think it was Eric that brought in the first original composition to the group, and I think that kind of set the stage and got everybody excited about writing. And you know, as is the normal procedure for my groups, I require the students to bring in charts.
Right.
Everybody has to bring in a chart, and so it just kind of blossomed into an ensemble where we have a lot of some originals, and I think it's really neat to have a combination of that and established literature as well. And I think that the originals stand up and are right there with what we have that's transcribed.
Absolutely, yeah, it's a really wonderful program this morning. So what do you guys have next for us?
Well, next we're going to do an original composition by our bassist, Drew Kaplan. And it is entitled, what's it entitled?
Atlantis.
Atlantis, yeah.
That's right. So we're going to bring you to the kingdom of Atlantis with Drew's composition now.
88.9 FM, the Frost Brasstet here live and direct in the Jazz Gallery. Dante Luciani, thank you so much for speaking with us. We'll speak a little bit later in the program, but for now I want to get back to the music with, like you said, an original of Drew Kaplan's entitled Atlantis.
Thank you. You're welcome.
The Frost Brasstet live and direct here on the Frost Jazz Hour, WDNA 88.9 FM. I'm your host, Philip Capuzzi. That last tune composed by Drew Kaplan, who is on bass, also featured on that tune, joined by Eric Stern on piano, Zach Levine on drums, Haoran Li on trombone, and Ethan Pires on trumpet. That tune entitled Atlantis. And with that, we're going to step aside briefly for some important messages from the station and come right back with more live music from the Jazz Gallery on the Frost Jazz Hour. Welcome back, WDNA 88.9 FM, into the Frost Jazz Hour here this fine Thursday morning. I'm your host, Philip Capuzzi. We have the Frost Brasstet with us in the Jazz Gallery this morning under the direction of Dante Luciani. And I also wanted to remind you, the listener, that if you're interested in donating to the station and supporting wonderful live programs like these, you can visit wdna.org, donate securely, it's tax deductible, and really goes so far to help maintain all of the different shows that we have here at the station that all of us here with the station put so much time and effort and love and passion into producing. So one more time, wdna.org. You can donate, support live shows like this, as well as all of the other uniquely produced shows that we bring to you on a 24-hour basis here at the station. So with that, we're going to bring you back to the music from the Frost Brasstet with the Sam Rivers composition entitled Point of Many Returns.
Thank you.
point of many returns as composed by Sam Rivers and performed live by the Frost Brasstet here on the Frost Jazz Hour, WDNA 88.9 FM, also streamed live on livestream.com as well as youtube.com. And wanted to let you, the listeners, know that next week we're going to have a really exciting group, the Frost Jazz Sextet, under the direction of Chuck Bergeron. And then the week after that, a rerun of a wonderful program with the Argentine vocalist Roxana Ahmed. And also to mention, on November 18th, not connected to the station, but being that Roxana Ahmed is so near and dear to the station, to mention it, that she was nominated for many a Latin Grammy, but specifically for her project Ontology, which was released in early April of this year. And the Latin Grammy premiere going to be aired on the 18th at 4 p.m., so very much looking forward to that. Roxana Ahmed, like I said, near and dear to the station. She's performed in the Jazz Gallery many a time. And like I said, on the 25th, so not next Thursday, but the Thursday after that, we will be re-airing a performance of hers from back in August of 2019. So with that, let's step back into the music. We're going to now move over to a Charles Lloyd composition entitled Forest Flower. And before we get into that, just to mention the musicians that you are hearing and seeing here this morning. We have Ethan Pires on trumpet, Haoran Li on trombone, Eric Stern on piano, Drew Kaplan on upright bass, and Zach Levine on drums. And you're listening to the Frost Brasstet. And with that, let's get back to the music. WDNA 88.9 FM, the Frost Jazz Hour. Thank you. And welcome back live and direct into the Frost Jazz Hour, WDNA 88.9 FM. You are listening to the Frost Brasstet here this fine Thursday morning on November 11th, the self-proclaimed Make-A-Wish Day. We already passed 11:11 a.m., but there's still 11:11 p.m. to get to. But with that said, that last tune, a wonderful composition of Charles Lloyd. Before we get to one more original composed by the trombone player in this ensemble, Haoran Li, I wanted to speak to Dante, the leader of this ensemble, once more. And I'm just kind of curious about the energy at Frost right now, a transitional semester and year in a lot of ways, bringing in some new faculty, obviously still, you know, staying cognizant of public health, and there's still some effects of the virus as we're transitioning out of some of those things from last year. And then really exciting semester for Frost as well, with the performance of Chucho Valdez at the Arst Center recently, and the studio jazz band under the direction of Etienne Charles performing there as well. So lots of exciting things happening at the school. And I guess, being that you've been with the school for such a long time and seen some of these changes, you know, as some of these mainstays have retired and stepped away, like Gary Lindsay and Gary Keller recently, as these new faces come in. So I'm just kind of curious for some of your thoughts on how that's all shaked out in the last few months.
Well, I think it's wonderful. Firstly, you know, we're bringing a lot more diversity into our faculty and into our student body as well. Both Marcus and Etienne are wonderful musicians, great, great people. I was just playing with Marcus last night with Chuck Bergeron's South Florida Jazz Orchestra. We did a concert at the Broward Center. And, you know, it's just, it's new blood, you know. And there's you can't go wrong when you bring in world-class faculty that are dedicated. And it's basically, you know, it's new, but it's also a continuation of the level of pedagogical excellence and the level of musical excellence that's been a part of this school for over 40 years. This is my 21st year as a full-time faculty member, and I'm excited. You know, it's like, you know, I feel like, you know, a kid in a candy store having these new faculty here. And I might also add one aspect of the school that is not so recent, but fairly recent, is the fact that we have some wonderful jazz principals. You know, not all of our students are jazz majors. And we have two examples here, I believe, in our two-thirds of our rhythm section with Zach and Drew. Drew, correct me if I'm wrong, but you didn't really play upright bass before this semester. And oh, okay. Practically.
Still.
But, I mean, the improvement that I've seen this semester in his playing is just, and everyone's, is just, it's really, it makes me, give me the warm and fuzzies, basically. So it's a great thing.
Yeah, so then just the last thing I wanted to ask you before we get into this last tune, for anyone that's interested in this group, are there any other performances coming up? And then also for yourself personally, if there's anything that you want to point the people towards, the
well, unfortunately, we don't have another performance. We performed twice this semester. We did a concert in Clark Recital Hall, and then we did our Monday Night Hang concert. So this is our final live concert for the semester. As for myself, last night we had this concert with the South Florida Jazz Orchestra, and coming up, I'm playing on December 5th at the Coral Springs Cultural Arts Center with another big band, a guy named Dick Lowenthal, who used to be a faculty member at the Manhattan School of Music. Wow. We're doing a jazz tribute to, I believe it's Duke Ellington. And other than that, for me, I'm just, I mostly just freelance, and I'm with this group one day, this group the next, so you never know where I'll be, but I like to stay active playing because it kind of keeps me on my toes, as do these students when I teach them, it's a learning experience for me as well as them, all the time. We never stop learning, as you know.
Yeah, exactly. That's the beauty of music.
It sure is.
I think what draws so many people to it. In these final few moments of the program, be sure to enjoy this as well, because like Dante said, there's no more performances for this group after this. Hopefully we can see this group come together in the future. But for the final tune of this morning, as we transition into the afternoon, we're going to listen to an original of the trombone player Haoran Li's, entitled Sunny Meets the Challenge of Monk. Here on the Frost Jazz Hour, I'm Philip Capuzzi. I'll be with you for the Latin Jazz Quarter as well after the news in a few moments, and with you next week. As always.
Thank you, Philip.
Thank you so much. Sonny Meets the Challenger Monk, as composed by Haoran Li, and also performed by him on trombone in this wonderful group, the Frost Brasstet. We've been coming to you live and direct since a little bit past the 11 o'clock hour. And for any of you who joined us at any point during the program, just to let you know, if it's your first time listening to the program, that we're here week in, week out, every Thursday from 11 a.m. until 12 noon, bringing in some of the premier ensembles from the Frost School of Music, as well as individuals who may have been at Frost in the past, or faculty at Frost, and some of the other situations that they have. So always very, very exciting live music here in the Jazz Gallery. Such a privilege and pleasure for us to be able to do this. And we're very grateful to the Frost School for bringing in these musicians every Thursday morning, and really bringing the heat at 11 a.m. on a Thursday morning. So just to bring you the musicians from this ensemble one more time, we had Ethan Pires on trumpet, Haoran Li on trombone, joined by Eric Stern on piano, Drew Kaplan on upright bass, and Zach Levine on drums. And throughout the course of the program, we had original compositions from both Eric Stern, Drew Kaplan, and then just a moment ago, Haoran Li, supplemented by three covers of tunes by Horace Silver, Sam Rivers, and Charles Lloyd, and under the direction of Dante Luciani as well. It's been a wonderful program here this morning. Looking forward to the Frost Jazz Sextet next week under the direction of Chuck Bergeron. And just to give you the schedule moving forward the next month or so, like I mentioned as well, Roxana Ahmed on November 25th will be airing a program of hers from back in August of 2019. Very excited for that, as we are all collectively celebrating her nominations for the Latin Grammy. Quite a few nominations for her April project, Ontology. Roxana Ahmed, very near and dear to the station, so we're all very happy for her and pulling for her as that comes up, which is actually also next Thursday at 4 p.m., November 18th, going to be the Latin Grammy premiere. And then after that rerun on the 25th, moving into December, we're going to have Steve Rucker, another one of the incredible mainstay professors at the Frost School of Music. He's going to bring in an ensemble that I'm always very happy to listen to, the Funk Fusion Ensemble. That's going to be on December 2nd. And then moving forward, a peer of mine who's been really focusing on developing his journey as a leader and writing a lot of music, a very exciting guitar player, Ben Thomas Taylor, will be in the Jazz Gallery on December 9th. And that's the schedule for the next couple of weeks. So for the final time, I am Philip Capuzzi. It's been my great honor to be back with you this week after stepping away last week, and a great thanks to our producer Alberto de la Ruguera for stepping in for the extensions program. And this has been the Frost Brasstet. It's been a great honor to share the music with you here this morning. Thanks as always for listening. Donate to the station if you can. Thanks to Dante Luciani, the director of this ensemble. And I hope you all have a wonderful rest to your day. I'll be with you for the Latin Jazz Quarter on the other side of the BBC News. 88.9 FM. See you guys next week.